weekend, because this is not about me teaching you, this is us growing together and learning together. Because I'm still learning every single day, I'm still trying to make improvements in my life. And I'm grateful for this opportunity to be able to do that, because again, I learn every day. And I did take to heart Pastor Smith's words, which were very inspiring. She said, reach out and touch someone. So, here we go. Here we go. I hope my words touch you, but more than anything, I appreciate your energy, because we're going to have fun, and unless you all speak up, I'm going to be really damn bored. Okay? So, jackets off, here we go. This is interactive, as you know. All right. Let's see. When we think of health, I was having a really nice conversation earlier with these senior students who are taking health, and I was asking them what their definition is of health, and they had some good answers. Again, I was very impressed because they were talking about eating, okay, you can think of that. They were talking about mind, body, relationships, all things that we'll be talking about today. And I am so impressed with that, because very often I think I've seen in my career as a visiting nurse and as a nurse for over 30 years, it's so polar. Either you're healthy or you're sick. So when we ask someone, you know, what do you consider health? Well, I'm not sick, I'm healthy. And I'd like to invite us to think of it more on a continuum. I'd like us to think of sickness at the bottom, very unhealthy, healthy, optimal health, and ultra health. And I believe that when we start thinking of it on a continuum, we realize that we have so many powerful choices that we can make along the way that will totally impact where we are on the continuum. And for me, that's what's so exciting about changing and growing and becoming more healthy. Also, in addition to that, I feel that when mind, body, and spirit are aligned, we can move along the path faster, with more fun and enjoyment. So that's what we'll talk about today. I'm glad you're here. In front of you, you have a prescription for a healthier you. Thank you for putting your name on it and dating it. And at the end, I will humbly ask you to sign it, and we'll talk about that as we go on. We'll choose one activity to be mindful, one to add movement to your life to have fun, and one to make connections. And Chickie was right. We don't need to be fearful or concerned of the word spiritual, because as we'll discuss in a few minutes, there's many more aspects to spirituality than just what we perceive often as just religion, which is nothing wrong with that, but there's other aspects too that I believe make a very vibrant and complete life.
Jesus.
So in terms of the mind, stress reduction, big buzzword these days. Unresolved stress, we know, creates wear and tear on the body. It's becoming totally scientific proof now that we can totally affect how we go through life, and that stress has a very negative impact on our health. I was driving one day as a visiting nurse 3 years ago, and driving in my Prius down the road, and all of a sudden I'm listening to a book on tape from a Cleveland clinic, and they're talking about your telomeres, which are the end of your, you know, on your genes, your DNA. And all of a sudden they said, your stress can decrease and shorten your telomeres. And all of a sudden it was like my world was rocked. I'm like, because I'm stressed, I totally have an impact to shorten the telomeres, so that my stress is totally contributing to shortening my life. And for me, as a nurse scientist, that was profound. I know it sounds a little deep and a little like, but it made me stop in my tracks, literally stop in my Prius on the side of the road and say, wow, okay, I'm in decent shape, my body, I work out, okay, I'm mindful, I have a community, a religion community, I have terrific friends, we were talking about that earlier, but my stress is not under control. I had things going on in my personal life that really were challenging. So I realized that's where I needed to make it. all of us here can probably come up with some areas of our lives that we'd like to, you know, change, do things differently. That's what this is all about. Just going on and continuing making small, simple changes. So, in terms of stress, you know, the goal in mindfulness and meditation is not to try to control life so that we'll not experience stress or frustration. Exactly. The secret is to be patient, offer ourselves compassion, which is something I've had to work on. More in the past, but I've had to work on that. And to respond to life's challenges from a place of calm and peace. That's not easy to do, but with more practice, and we're going to go over some ways to do that, I promise it's very achievable. Again, even what the gentleman this morning, early on before the main speaker was saying, you know, the deep breathing, something as simple as that, and we'll go through that. I love the science of it, because it's so easy and elegant when you think about it. You're breathing in rich oxygen that's flowing through your bloodstream, going to all your major organs, and you're breathing out carbon dioxide. It's as simple as that. More oxygen in, just think about it. Think about it coursing through your veins, going to your heart, going through your lungs, providing nutrition, going to your brain, helping you to think clearer. It's scientific, guys, it works. Elegant. I'm gonna have everyone try that right now. We're jumping right in. Who has practiced deep breathing? Thanks for sharing. Have you found it effective?
Yeah.
No? I bet you.
Absolutely.
Can you speak to what it's done for you?
Just giving me better clarity. Normally I breathe in the morning. I do exercises in the morning, and it just helps to start my day off.
Come on up.
Yeah.
Want to lead it?
Sure.
Okay. I feel you can handle it.
All right, so when you breathe, the lungs are pear-shaped, and you want to get that bottom reservoir of air. Most people breathe very shallow, and they breathe the upper portion of their lungs. So when you breathe in, your stomach should go out. When you breathe out, your stomach should go in. So one way to do it is if you just want to put your hand on your stomach.
And this was not planned, by the way. This is what, when you allow the moment to take over, this is what beautifully unfolds. Thank you. Thank you.
So when you breathe in, your stomach should slightly go up. Okay, so let's all just try together. We do this too. Put your tongue to the roof of your mouth, push it to the back of your teeth. All right, so you're gonna breathe in, hold, and exhale. Breathing in through your nose and out through your nose. Sometimes they have two different types of breath. If you breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth, that's referred. Referred to it as a warrior's breath, and in through your nose and out through your nose is referred to as a scholar's breath. They both have different things that that they help with. But generally for health, in through your nose and out through your nose is the best.
Except like me, if your nose gets very congested, I have to breathe out my mouth. So that's the difference. You can't really do this wrong if you're breathing deeply. You really can't. And it's so effective, and I'm telling you, it seems so basic, but this works. Okay.
Thank you. Another way that you can kind of monitor yourself is if you lay flat on the floor and just take a little small book and put it on your stomach and make sure that the book is rising and descending. So that's another way you can check to see if your breath is doing right. So let's just try 10 together. Okay.
How about three? Because
three.
It's 10,
okay.
3, 5.
That's it.
And I'm going to talk really fast from now on, let me tell you.
All right, so breathe in, holding, exhale, again, hold, exhale.
Now slowly, I'd like to invite you to keep your shoulders down if you can. We don't want to use our shoulders. You want to feel right from our belly.
Left. last one, inhale. Holding, and exhale. So four stages.
Thank you. So in mindfulness meditation, you're encouraged to observe wandering thoughts as they drift through the mind. You can see your thoughts and feelings tending to be different patterns. Why am I doing this? Oh my gosh, I have to be somewhere, I have to go to the dry cleaners, I have to do this. That's okay. Over time, you become more aware, and you're gonna start to let them go. In concentration meditation, you focus on a single point. It can be a candle for you, or it can be, again, just observing your breath, or it can be repeating a single word, like, you know, when you've heard om. That's called concentration meditation. In guided meditation, a leader guides you through his or her own words with vivid images or an image of your choice. Think of a beach scene or a place that you like to go, your happy place. Calming. Through trial and error, you'll find out which ones you like. I know you all know how to Google, so I just encourage you to Google whatever type of meditation you'd like to learn. There are so many good ones online. And you'll find out whose voice you like, who resonates with you, what words they use. I wish we had more time today. We don't, but I'll tell you, it really works. So I'm going to ask everyone, for 2 minutes, we'll do a guided meditation, which will be very fast. I'll ask everyone to either close their eyes or just gently look down, whatever you're comfortable with. I ask that your legs not be crossed, in front of you, relaxed. And we'll start, thanks to our friend, with two deep breaths. In the nose and out the mouth. And I'll ask you to start and let go of anything you might be thinking about that's taking you away from the here and now. And just focus on yourself and your time. And I'd like you to think about perhaps what brought you here. And what you feel you'd like to get out of it in terms of a healthier you. I invite you to choose your happy place, where you feel calm, where you feel empowered, and you see yourself as the best possible you. I invite you to go a little bit deeper and really think about what that looks like. Where you are, who you're with, what sounds you hear, what you smell, now think to yourself, how can I achieve that in my life on a more constant basis? How can I go to my happy place more often? Because you do have that control. You have the ability every day to go there. As you softly come to, open your eyes. I'd like you to write down on the prescription for you your first mindful goal. And I'd like you to just think for a second, to be really clear that I'd like it to be a SMART goal. I'd like it to be specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and timely. So meaning, I'm going to try to do deep breathing twice a day for 10 minutes every day for the next week. Or whatever you'd like to try. Again, you could add laughter. In terms of stress management, it could be laughter. It could be a different type of meditation. It could be listening to a meditation online. You could be just sitting calmly for 5 minutes and just listening to yourself and letting everything else go. Give yourself that gift today. Being more mindful in the moment. I'll just share with you. The reason this is so important to me is because on that continuum of good choices, I saw my sister be challenged with chronic illness and acute diseases. And my sister and I were very close. She was a second grade school teacher. She worked at a Catholic school. And we were very close growing up. She was very creative, very artistic. We used to do crafts together. And we slept in the attic room all of our lives together. And she started to gain weight in her late 20s and 30s, and started to get on medicine for arthritis and knee trouble and back pain and knee pain, and then diabetes, hypertension, and a whole cascade of chronic and acute diseases. And at 50, had a quadruple bypass. And had major cardiac issues from medications that she'd been on. And at 53, she died of a heart attack. And it was truly my greatest fear realized, because I had already lost a sister with Down syndrome. So I lost both my sisters. And I saw how Pat's life could have been so much more richer and so much happier. It was one just constant struggle with health that didn't have to be there. And I know that by making different decisions, we can really affect our lives. So that's why I do this, to honor her. So in terms of physical exercise, we all know of, you know, cardiac endurance exercises. But I invite you to think of other types of exercise. Endurance exercises are terrific. Keep strong, but I really maintain as we get older, we need to add in flexibility exercises for our joints, strength exercises for our muscles, to be independent, to carry groceries, just to live our lives. You know, whether you use a resistance band or your own body weight, I really encourage us to do stretching every day. Balance exercises too are huge. I saw my home care patients with many falls. And you know, whether you want to start to do heel-to-toe walking, I have a girlfriend that just started Tai Chi, she just lost 24 pounds, and she just feels that she has a new lease on life. And it's also good for meditation as well, Tai Chi. So what are you all doing now in terms of physical exercise? Do you make it a daily part of your life? Or is it something that you just kind of do, say, oh, when I get around to it, I'll do it? Would anyone like to just share what they found that's worked for them, any routine?
I think the biggest thing for me, I often tell myself, you know, I'm going to exercise, and I do it a lot, but I found that when I make myself accountable to somebody, and I'll just tell somebody else, I'm going to do the treadmill today for a half an hour, I'm going to do some weights, that I don't lie about it. I do it. When I tell myself that, I don't always get it done. So the accountability factor has made a really big difference for me.
That's terrific. And how do you do that? Via email, via text?
Yes, I just email a friend. I used to say I'm going to do it or I'll cut off my finger, but I don't have to do that anymore. I just tell somebody else I'm going to do it.
How many fingers do you have? Thank you. You're absolutely right. Having someone you're accountable to or a workout buddy, very, very effective. Fantastic. So you made it more a part of your life. Yeah.
What did she say to me?
Speak louder, please.
I said that I've been doing yoga for a while, but recently I started to do it every day, and it's really helped with stress and just making me feel so much better.
I love to hear that. And I'm going to slip slides here for a second. But okay, here's Ruby. Ruby goes to my gym. Ruby's 93. Okay? I mean, she's doing something right. She lifts weights. She shows up looking like this. She didn't have her pearls on today. Sometimes she shows up with her pearls. But she's serious. She gets there and she lifts weights. She's not lifting heavy-duty weights, but she's lifting enough to keep her muscles strong. 93, she's doing something right. So I'm very inspired by her. And I have to work on adding everything in. Like I said, I can do the cardio, then I don't want to lift weights, and it's a pain in the butt. You just got to do it. Whether it's having an accountability buddy or making it just part of your routine on your calendar. Those are two really good ideas. So, we're going to go through this quickly because, again, I have 15 minutes and I apologize, but I think you all understand the physical part of it. It's just doing something daily that's fun to you, though. I encourage you, more than anything, to pick something that you like doing. Don't do it all, I have to go lift weights because that's what I'm supposed to do. No, do what you like to do. Whether it's kickboxing, a friend of mine is starting a Pilates. She said, I always wanted to try it. You know, do you like to dance? Do you like to jump rope? You know, these are all viable things. Just do what you like to do because then you'll stick with it. So I invite you to write down one body goal that you're going to set for yourself. Again, you can be specific. Please write something that's realistic, something that you'll actually consider doing, because this is all about you. Not to have you sitting there doing nothing.
Oh, man. Get
your butt moving over there, girl. Come on. The divinity piece, is that's what's going to flow into you? Yeah, you got to start doing it though. Brave soul out there who would like to be proud and commit to it. Come on, who wants to share? All right, she's a brave soul. Please just be loud and be proud.
Okay, I'm proud. I'm going to walk at least 2 miles, at least twice a week.
Beautiful. All right. And you're going to do it. You're going to do it. Beautiful. Thank you. Anyone else? All right. You're another brave soul. Yay.
I'm going to walk 30 minutes every day.
Yes.
30 minutes every day.
Good.
Are you a walker?
Yes.
You're a walker. Have you done it every day consistently?
Yes.
Oh, then you can stretch yourself a little bit. Hold on. It's great you're doing it, but I'm going to invite you. Julie?
Yes.
I'm going to invite you, Julie, to stretch yourself just a little bit.
But I do it during my lunch time, so.
Add some ankle weights there, Julie.
Huh?
Add some ankle weights. Some weights in your hands.
I was just going to say, exactly.
Resistance.
See, he's listening.
I'll give you an extra 5 minutes.
You're listening.
That's my boss.
No, sir. So you will allow Julie, during her lunch hour, to spend that extra couple minutes. What was your name?
Steven.
Steven? Could you say that loud and proud so that we have it all on record?
Sure, definitely. It's going to help reduce our
medical costs. What are we committing to, Julie? What are we committing to for Julie?
Helping Julie get that extra 5 minutes in, so she gets, you know, but adding some additional, you know, either weights or some resistance this way. She
I don't even need to be up here. Like,
she gets more out of that 30
minute
walk.
You guys set up. That's fantastic. That's exactly it. Just stretching yourself. Just considering the possibility of doing something a little bit different. That's a little bit out of your comfort zone. Would you be willing to entertain that, Julie?
Yes.
Because you didn't have the obstacle to time. Now that was taken care of. We all don't have a boss like Stephen. That's terrific. How about one more? Oh, thanks, Joanne. Thank you. Loud and proud.
It seems a little silly, but my dog is big, so it's like a full body workout when we walk. So, and he loves doing it. He's sort of my accountability partner. He comes and looks at me like, are we going now? And I'm like, no. So, I'm really just going to...
State your goal, please.
Well, I said walking or hiking with him every day for at least 15 minutes or more every day. Because I don't do it every day. I get it done maybe twice a week. I really want to do it every day for at least 15 minutes.
Thanks, Joanne. So now you're making yourself healthier. You're making your dog healthier.
Yeah.
Why did you think that was silly?
Well, because it's just walking with your dog, you know, and I mean, he's, you know.
We're getting back to, it's not just a nurse, I'm not just a nurse. You know, it's not silly. That's fantastic. You're
well,
setting a goal for yourself.
It's fun, and you're outside, you know. The hard part is when the weather's not nice, and then still saying, okay, bundle up, cover up, whatever, and just go, because he doesn't care. So,
you think you can do it?
I
believe you can do it. Yay! No obstacles. You're just going to do it. That's beautiful. Alrighty, so moving to the third part, spirit. Spirit, I believe, encompasses more than spiritual. Spiritual is profoundly important. But I'd like us to invite a new way to look at it in terms of meaning and purpose in our life. In terms of, yes, community, religious, in terms of values. What values do we hold deep to us and what's important in our life? Are we really honoring those in how we live our spiritual life? Most stressors and come out of some form of challenges with relationships, whether it's values or value conflict, or the search for fulfillment or the meaning or purpose in one's life. Effective coping skills that help us to resolve those causes of stress with the effective relaxation skills, return the body to homeostasis. Think about your relationships in your family, community, work, social, religious. Are there any relationships that you would like to improve? What goal can you set now to make that happen? Are you being true to yourselves, doing what you want to do in this one great life that we are blessed with? Any value conflict rearing its ugly head? No, but you're like, well, that's okay. I'll just put that aside. Have you found your purpose in life? Do you wake up excited about the day? I see a shake over there. You do wake up excited? Do you mind sharing? I'd love to hear. We'd love to hear.
Well, I think when I wake up, I'm thankful that I'm waking up.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
And then I look forward to what I get to do that day. You have helped. That's the way I look at it every day.
And your name was
Earthling.
That's a beautiful name, too. I love that because there's a whole gratitude piece there. And I do believe, actually, I was going to mention that next, that that goes along with the whole spirituality piece, being grateful for what we have. I actually have a gratitude journal that I've been doing for well over a year now. And every day I just record three things that I'm grateful for. And sometimes, you know, they're as basic as, but really not as basic. I woke up today.
What am I going to do with this day?
Exactly. And you have the whole day ahead of you, 24 hours. Yes. Thanks for sharing. That's absolutely true, and that's a huge piece of it. So, you know, have you found your purpose? Do you wake up excited? Do you have purposeful activities, activities that you really enjoy doing that are coming from your heart? Yeah, we all have to do activities that we don't always love. Sometimes jobs, there's components to it we don't love. But fundamentally, are we really doing what we want to do? If not, what small tweaks, what small changes can we do to get there? As students, you don't always have as much control. But what activities can you add to your day that really make you joyful? I invite you to think about that. So, right now, please go to the spirit section, and I'd like you to think about one goal you could set for yourself, whether it's in terms of relationships with your family, whether it's meaning, adding meaning and purpose to each day, like Hercule, who wakes up excited to start the day. These are conscious choices, folks. These are not just I'm stuck in the same day in and day out. Whether it's being more involved with the church, temple community. Whether it's social, getting together with your friends. I talked to two fabulous friends back there, ladies. One is from our sponsor. What were your names?
Donna.
Donna and Kellyanne, who have a nice four-year friendship. I walked in, I could just see the joy between the two of them. They were laughing and just, you know, sharing something funny. It was just precious. That's what spiritual connection is all about, connecting to the others. Would anyone like to share their spiritual goal that they have set today at the Healthier You Conference? There's a woman right here, and will you be loud and proud, Angelina?
Yes.
Okay, loud and proud.
Well, I have to try and let go of trying to control coworkers' dispositions because I wake up happy every morning that I'm alive and look forward. I thank God every morning for my waking up. And then I have to go and try to, you know, it's hard because you have so many dispositions and there's a lot of them that just are so negative all the time. So I have to try to let go that I don't have control over this and just set by example. So that's what that is.
I love that one because it speaks to so many different things. It speaks to you wanting to control other people, which we all know. Can we do that?
No.
Can't do it. Gregory's saying up here, can't do it. You can't. Say it louder. You can't.
You can't. I wake up every morning happy, and I go to work, and they wonder why I'm happy.
Yeah.
And I tell them I woke up this morning, and I'm a mailman, and 34 years I come to work and be happy.
I'm pretty impressive. 34 years.
And I'm happy, and I coach football. I coach youth, 8-year-olds. So you know it's a lot going on, and I'm dealing with a lot of females and their sons. And they are so baby to their kids, to their sons, and they don't want them to get hurt. But football is a contact sport. That you, I let them know. You gotta let them go. And let me do what I need to do. I love it. And I just love it. I'm involved with my church and everything. I need to calm down. Because I'm so busy and getting back to the goal, I think I'll be walking that 2 miles because if she walking 2 miles, I guess
she. So, you're going to kindly, or the kindness of your heart, Gregory, be your Dina's accountability partner.
Yes.
What a guy. What a guy. See, you're setting a goal for yourself. Yeah, all right, it works. That's kind of you. And I would have used you as an example, as someone who's leading a robust life, making community connections, helping others, working a job where you're helping so many others. Yet I invite you to take time for yourself, which is what all of us need to do.
Yeah, I do. I have a one night meeting for myself. I go home.
Beautiful. How about anyone else? I know we only have a few more minutes, but we'll be wrapping up. No worries. Oh, yes! One of my nursing students who wanted to speak up, I said, I know she's going to talk. Yeah!
I love you.
They came in so quiet. I want to hear their voices.
In my spiritual role, I said, being more at peace with myself emotionally.
And please speak louder and prouder, please.
And building a relationship with my mom. But I feel like what takes all of that away from me is because I've been dancing ever since I was like five, like after my dad died. That's like my whole structure with her. So I found a peace in that. So anytime I go through something with my mom or even at work, I just go to like a different place in my head and I just think of like being on stage and just dancing. And I feel like that actually helps me a lot. And with my emotional was like, because I grew up like insecure with my body and stuff like that, and I've been called like ugly in the past and stuff, so I had like a big problem with that, and I wanted to actually fix that because I don't want to grow up and just be like, okay, well, I'm still ugly or something like that, or think that I can't have what everybody else has. Like, I want to grow up and say, I am a queen, I am beautiful, and I can do anything. The fact that someone couldn't hear what you said, what do they want to do? Be at peace with myself emotionally.
I'd like to hear you speak loud and say, I am a beautiful woman.
I'm a beautiful woman.
Yes. I have so very much to offer this world.
I have so very much to offer this world.
I am proud of who I am.
I am proud of who I am.
Yes, you are.
I am loving myself.
I am loving myself.
Exactly the way I am right now.
Exactly the way I am right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
You are beautiful.
And you have everything you need right now.
Yes.
Your smile is amazing. Keep lighting the world. So in closing, I was going to show Aunt Camille, who is my 93-year-old sister-in-law's aunt, who is living a life of connection, family, blessing, at a party, shoving the bottle of champagne. Aunt Camille gets it. Aunt Camille gets to be vibrant, and she understands. She plays. She has fun. She sends texts out. She sends texts. She only texts in capital, not text. She sends out on Facebook messages. She only uses capital letters. She doesn't understand that that's shouting. When I asked her what she considered was health, she said, I have problems, but I don't dwell on them. I have family. I keep myself active. I volunteer. I go to church every week. Aunt Camille is a good example of someone who's living a life. So, in closing, be courageous. Thank you so much for the examples you've given me now. I really appreciate your participation and being here today. Please be courageous and take ownership of your own health. keep your mind, body, and spirit aligned for true harmony and healing in your life. And true healing can only occur when all three are aligned. First, you got here today. Awesome. Second, you created a prescription that you have in front of you with goals on them. Fantastic. The third step is to hang your prescription in a place that you see, whether it's on your refrigerator, whether it's in your bedroom, where you're going to see it often. Renew your prescription, add to it, make substitutions. Keep growing and challenging yourself, like Julie back there. I guarantee you, you'll be stronger, you'll have more energy, you'll enjoy better sleep, you will have a longer, healthier life with more choices and more fun. Now everyone, stand up, because you're going to take the pledge. And I promise you'll be out of here in 1 minute. Everybody's doing the evaluation, I know. All right, right hand up, please. And loud and proud, I hereby promise.
I hereby promise.
To take charge of my own health.
To take charge of my own health.
To fill this prescription to the best of my ability.
To fill this prescription to the best of my ability.
And to make conscious daily choices toward wellness. I will achieve my health goals. Because I am a badass individual. Thank you all very, very much.